What is the merit order effect, and how could renewables decrease your bills?
In liberalized electricity markets, electricity produced by generators is bought by retailers at the wholesale price and distributed to their customers. Quick disclaimer, I'll be making some simplifications in this video, and I'll only talk about the wholesale spot market. But it's important to know that electricity markets also include bilateral agreements and other markets such as capacity markets. But essentially, supply of electricity by generators needs to meet demand, also known as load, at all times, because you want to avoid thefts. So how does it work? Well, generators sell electricity at different prices depending on their costs of generating that electricity. In other words, depending on their marginal variable slash operating costs. So, since renewables such as wind and solar have close to zero marginal costs, because once your turbine is built, the wind does most of the work for you, bids from renewable generators are much lower, and thus so are prices. In contrast, fossil fuel plants' operational costs due to high fuel costs are higher. Then you get generation technologies such as nuclear, lignite and coal, gas, which can be divided into CCGT, which is combined cycle gas turbines, which are more efficient and have lower variable costs but are less good for flexibility, and OCGT, open cycle gas turbines, which are peaking plants. And finally, oil. This is a big simplification too, as for example, nuclear acts as a base load and can't really be turned up and down much. I have also not talked about storage, which at the moment acts as a price taker, but in the future could potentially change merit order curves. So this kind of marginal pricing causes the merit order effect. So why do fossil fuels make the wholesale prices higher? The wholesale price is set by the highest successful bid. So where demand is met by supply, that's the price. Right now, even if you have a sliver of gas being dispatched, then it sets the price. So let's see what effect having more renewables has. Well, let's first keep the demand and time here fixed. If you increase the amount of renewables up to this point, then the spot prices go down. In real life, as the capacity of renewables increases, more baseload and semi-flexible generation sources, such as gas, gets displaced. At the moment, this means several things. By increasing renewable capacity, you can limit the amount of hours where fossil fuels set the price, since they're being pushed outside the supply mix. But at those specific high-priced times, renewable generators get to benefit from the surplus prices, which helps them recover their high capital costs. But it also depends on CFD agreements, but I won't get into that into this video. I put an article by IRENA in the description that goes through this point. Another effect you get by increasing renewable capacity is what we call price cannibalization, where more renewables which generate at the same time decrease each other's prices and can even lead to negative pricing. This is why some reforms are starting to happen, as marginal pricing could be a barrier for more investment if generators can't even recoup their high capital costs, which could slow down the energy transition. Unfortunately, this decrease in electricity prices can many times be obscured by higher gas prices, especially when fuel costs increase, as we saw when Russia invaded Ukraine, which then increased the overall price. Another issue with having gas setting the electricity prices is that gas prices tend to be cleared on an international market, something you can't fully control as a country. And furthermore, if gas prices are indexed or heavily correlated with oil prices, then a change in the oil prices can have an effect on gas prices and subsequently electricity prices. Also, if you are dependent on fossil fuel imports and fossil fuels take a large share of your electricity mix, then the country can be impacted by currency exchange risks. This interesting paper talks about how the devaluation of the pound due to Brexit had a negative effect on electricity prices in the UK. Another important thing to mention is that wholesale electricity prices are only a section of people's bills alongside other charges and taxes. But it's also important to consider capital costs, as renewables have high capital costs but low operational ones, which tends to be the opposite for fossil fuels. All in all, electricity markets are quite complex, with many different actors involved. What is key is to increase the share of renewables immensely, but it's also very important to increase flexibility via energy storage, demand-side response, and other tools. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video and want to learn more about climate change and energy, don't forget to subscribe.